Now, 10 days, 10 nights of protests. Last night, a group once again gathered in downtown Lexington to march and speak out against racial injustice. LEX18's Alex Valverde is live in downtown right now with details in this LEX18 news update.
Good morning, Claire. Before protesters started marching last night, some of them read aloud the names of every black victim of police violence in the last 5 or 6 years. And we're told that that took more than 30 minutes to do. After the crowd moved to Main Street, where they picked up the energy with song, before going to their first stop, Cheapside Park, the site of Lexington's slave trade, with a name that remains a reminder of that painful past. They then continued down Short Street to Broadway and then up Vine Street. And they stopped for a moment of silence at the bus station, where there are posters of Breonna Taylor and George Floyd. The march ended at the courthouse, a peaceful night with no reported arrests or violence. Organizers and protesters say they'll continue to speak out for those who have lost their lives and to push for police reform.
I think that the end of protest signifies the end of police brutality or the end of racism in this country. I still think that's a long-term effort, but I think that this is just something we're going to have to continue to face, but at least now people are knowledgeable and at least people know that we're willing to fight.
And again, the protests over the last 10 days here in Lexington have mostly been peaceful. However, there was a fight that broke out here in downtown on Saturday night, and police are still investigating. No charges have been filed.